Hello students, let us understand Human Development Index. We now know what human development is. So how can we identify that whether in a country's human development is good or not? Well, for that we have a parameter called HDI, Human Development Index. This was propounded by Amartya Sen. He is one of the leading economists of India. In the year 1990, and after that year the entire theory of HDI has been presented in for each country in the report of UNDP. UNDP is United Nations Development Program. So what is this HDI? How can we get to know that in each country what is the level of human development? Country develops, good. Infrastructure develops, very good. But does human develop? How will we know that? What will be the criteria? So there are three criteria set. We will learn each of them. The first one is life expectancy index. Life expectancy as in how long will a person live after his birth, but how long will he live healthy? So here the longevity and the health, good life and long life is considered. So it is highest 83.6 years and the lowest is 20 years. And in 2015, according to the report, Indian longevity, Indian life expectancy index, LEI, was 68 years. Students, you have to remember this. But to share with you for your knowledge, after our independence, the life expectancy was only 36 years, which is raised above 76 years currently. So you can imagine the quality of life of people has improved, the medical facilities have improved, people's health consciousness has improved. So definitely we are doing good, but we can do even better, right? So when you are young, stop eating junk, or maybe avoid, or maybe lessen it. Work upon your health, your fitness. Regular exercise, yoga, cycling, playing some sport can really help this LEI go high, right? Next is education index. So education, literacy, what it is, first of all, we need to know. So any person with the age of 7 who knows to read or write and understand one language is known as literate. Now, how much education he receives is all about EI, education index. But it is divided in two areas. Mean year of schooling. So how many years of schooling will a person in average, and expected year of schooling. How much, as per the current situation, is it expected for students, for population to be educated? So here in mean year of schooling, 25 years is considered. So if, when you grow up, you go into your schooling age, you are 3, your prep section. By the time you clear your 10th, you are 15 or 16. When you finish 12th, you are almost adult. When you finish your graduation, you are almost 23. And by the time you finish your PG, post-graduation, you are almost 25. So the logic of 25 years here is given. Now, the highest mean year of schooling is 13.3 years. Lowest is 0 because there are so many people never going to school. And in 2015, it was just 5.4 years. Just imagine. Students, in 2009, we have had this thing. Education policy. We had a bill in Lok Sabha, in Rajya Sabha, wherein free and compulsory education was given. Still, the mean year is lesser. Now, can you relate that when the schooling years of a person is so less, obviously, he won't be that super skilled. And that's probably the reason of unemployment. And because he is unemployed, he goes poor. Because he is poor, his kids will again not go to school. So this vicious circle is unending. The next is expected year of schooling. How many years is it expected that a person might go to school? So highest is 18 years for 18 years of life, as in when the child goes to school he is 3 and plus 18, so almost 21. So it is expected that maximum people will at least get graduated. Least is 0 years, because as I said, there are many people who never go to school. And the average is 11.7 years. It is expected that at least for 11.7, let us take it 12. At least for 12 years in life. So now tell me, 12 is up to 9th standard, right? So under this new education bill, according to the Free and Compulsory Education 2009 bill, at least till 9th standard, a person should get education. Is this EYS, expected year of schooling. And income index. Now see, how long will you live? How healthy will you be? After being healthy, how much mentally healthy you will be depends on your education. And finally, why we are doing all this is for money. So comes income index, how much will you earn? So there are two concepts, the gross domestic product and gross national income. So how many, what is GDP first of all? GDP is in a given year, in all the sectors, what amount of product or service is manufactured. Say for example, in India, entirely, the primary sector gives $1 billion products. And the secondary and tertiary sector gives another $2 billion. So the economy of India, the GDP of India in the year 2019 would be $3 trillion. So that combination of value in terms of money is known as GDP. But from GDP, we cannot find out what people earned. We can only find out how many rupees worth goods are made. So in order to find out what is the income of people, there is yet another concept called gross national income, per capita national income. Say suppose I have 20 chocolates and I have 20 students in my class, I give one chocolate to each of them. So per capita, per person's head came one chocolate. But now when I have 20 and if I have only 10 students, I'll be able to give 2 chocolates each. Or maybe if I have only 4 students, I'll be able to give 5 chocolates per person. So I hope you are understanding that lesser the population, more would be the division. The amount would be bigger. And now you might understand that why Indian national income per capita would be less. Because goods that are made can be exported outside, but the income is going to get divided within the heads of the nation. And India being very populous, we cannot have a big share. If I had 20 students, it's only one chocolate that everybody would have received. But if I had only 4, it would be 5 chocolates per head, right? So here comes per capita gross national income and per capita gross national product. So in 2015, per head income per year was $5,497 and per capita product was $5,238. And it is based on purchasing power parity theory. It is very, very popularly known in economics as PPP. So this purchasing power parity theory shows that what is the capacity of people in any country to purchase? What is his purchasing power? So this is income index. Students, economics is easy to understand, but technical things has to be remembered. Specifically this data, you have to remember the data because it will make your answer sound technical. I hope you are clear with the three parameters. In any country, to measure what is the human development, these are the three areas, the three parameters. The first one is how long and healthy the person will live, what we call as LEI. Second, how much he studies, that is EI, education index. And third, what money he makes out of it is II, income index. In the next class, we will learn the ranking of countries in terms of HDI. See you in the next class. Bye bye.